Hello there, audience. I am your host, Gold Nuclear, and yes, I'm back to Raw, and yeah, I know I missed SmackDown, but honestly, I think Nelson did a... Okay, let's see, what did he tell me to write down? A better job than me? And he thinks I should make him the full-time host of both brands? No. Let's jump headfirst into Raw. We start with Miz TV, as Drew keeps on getting interrupted by Miz and his TV. Morrison, I don't know where he is, but I suppose has something to deal with reasons. As something that I've learned, Drew does not like getting interrupted by people. So, he takes out his pain by headbutting him. Well, after that, Miz gets so frustrated that he takes himself out of the Elimination Chamber. Good to know. We now get Matt Riddle with Lucha House Party versus The Hurt Business. The Hurt Business seems to be doing pretty good. And right when I think this match catches up and gets its speed without fault, well, faults happen. First, Cedric wasn't in the proper place to catch Lince Dorado. I think I horribly murdered that pronunciation. So he had to slide back and it looked awkward. Then Dorado doesn't connect with the kick. Then Shelton goes over the top rope of his own volition. And after we come back from a commercial break, Hurt Business do the fun tag thing. They absolutely dominate with hard strikes into the corner, but Metalik does an amazing DDT to stop the beating. He makes the hot tag, and here comes Riddle with a flurry of strikes to Cedric. But MVP makes a tag to help out Cedric. Right whenever it seems Riddle will lose, Lucha House Party jumps in, and somehow doesn't get disqualified for jumping MVP. Is that bias towards faces? I feel like that's bias. My favorite part of this match was whenever Riddle connected that knee out of nowhere to Shelton as he was trying to get Dorado into a powerbomb. And Riddle wins it for Lucha House Party and himself. Oh, hi, Bobby. I just want to thank, personally, Kofi Kingston and Xavier Woods for calling out Adam Pearce for not putting Kofi in the Elimination Chamber prior. Blame Adam Pearce. I blame him for many things. Now time for Asuka and Charlotte versus Lacey and Peyton Royce. Oh, wait, there's a promo first. I feel like we should listen to this. Nelson, quick, show us the highlights, but cut it up so it doesn't look like we get blocked by random Middle Eastern countries.
Time, honey. Charlotte, I want to kindly thank you for getting yourself disqualified last week and ensuring that I get exactly what I rightfully deserve. A chance at the Raw Women's Championship. You were kind of heartbroken. So me and Pepe have brought you a little something in honor of Valentine's Day yesterday. It's one of those little sweetheart candies, you know, that has little words on it. This one says, bite me.
Well, that was pointless. Also, I kind of feel bad for Peyton. I mean, she's just getting squashed at this point. I don't know why Lacey doesn't want to get tagged in. Wait, no, Lacey, where are you going?
Charlotte, I'm pregnant.
Woo! I can call me daddy.
No, I will not call you daddy, Rick. Okay, look. I'm going a little off script here because I couldn't really exactly write down what I wanted to say here. Nielsen heard my firsthand reactions in an alternate timeline. So I'll just sum that up for you. Why now? I understand she's like legitimately pregnant, so that, you know, there gets the pass, but like, why is it treated like a heel move? Like she's like, oh no, I don't want a championship opportunity against Asuka in the Elimination Chamber. I might get hurt. I'm pregnant. It makes no sense, and it's even more awkward whenever you're considering that Lacey has a husband, and storyline-wise, Rick is supposed to be the sugar daddy to Lacey. It also makes it even more awkward considering a tweet that Becky Lynch made a couple years back, whenever she was on top of the world, saying that Lacey is similar to Charlotte in many ways, both coming from the Carolinas, and that Rick, or Lacey's mother should, or no, that Lacey should ask her mother, Lacey's mother, if Rich was nature boying around that time that she was conceived. This leads to many a question, and I'm going to move on from that. Miz versus Kofi Kingston. If Kofi wins, he's in the Elimination Chamber. And, well, yay. No idea where I was going with that. So, Kofi goes high-flying and connects with a clothesline from the top rope. The two play Ring Around the Rosie briefly before Miz tries to take out Kofi. Let's just say he fails and ends up getting kicked in the head. Eventually, Miz takes back the advantage by saying, hey, come back from a commercial break. Miz is punching Kofi, but Kofi reverses by taking out the leg. But Miz connects with a DDT, then throws Kofi out for some reason, but he throws him back in just as confusingly. Then connects with a double hand fist move from the top rope. We get some knees to the face, and Kofi punches back. Miz, I think the reason Kofi keeps on kicking out of all your moves is because, well, you haven't hit your finisher yet! Kofi gains momentum after a selection of drop kicks, and boom, drop! Kofi goes for the Trouble in Paradise, but that gets reversed into a roll-up. Kofi kicks out of that and connects with the SOS, but yet a kick out from Miz again. Oh, and Kofi, hey, he connects with a phenomenal crossbody, but Miz rolls it into a pin attempt. I mean, come on, that's just fun. This leads to the figure four leg lock. Miz tries to go for the skull crushing finale, but that gets reversed into a roll up, which then positions Kofi to finally connect with the Trouble at Paradise and win. So, we get Shayna versus Lana next. Okay, Shayna starts by working on Lana's arm. We get some elbows to the chest and then a slap. You know what? I'm done. I'm done playing the middle man in this rivalry. Shayna, kill her! Yes, knee her in the face. Clinch in the submission. Good. Good. Now don't let go as she taps out. Yay! Oh yeah, a gauntlet match. I say this like I don't care. I actually really like these gauntlet matches. Are some of the most fun I have ever. I think they peaked whenever Seth Rollins did his cool thing. So the gauntlet starts between Kofi and AJ. Nice. AJ immediately goes for a bad knee, but then gets a good knee straight to his face. Every time AJ looks to get the advantage, he face plans into either the turnbuckle, a knee, or an elbow. But AJ eventually does take lead on that leg, just to get, oh hey look, elbowed. Kofi does a great move on AJ on the outside. Nilsson, hurry, show Woods getting killed by Omos.
Serenade from Woods. Oh my God! A sense of hold of Xavier Woods!
With ease!
It's defenseless!
Oh no!
Oh my God!
Getting back to the match, AJ's taking full control over Kofi's bad leg. But we do see another SOS from Kofi. AJ finishes Kofi's night by connecting the phenomenal forearm. Now on to the next person. Howdy, Drew. Drew begins to just ragdoll AJ across the ring. He then connects with two boots back to back to the face. A little later, we see Drew working on that arm of AJ, and all I have to say is, ouch. We see AJ fight back with slaps and punches. Drew then does a reverse Alabama slam on AJ, runs for a claymore, but gets kicked in the head. Eventually, AJ kicks Drew in the head on the outside of the ring as well. It seems Drew has a problem of always gaining then losing the moment. That's just like the thing that AJ struggled for. I wonder if Drew will win. Oh, and hey look, Drew beats AJ! Yahoo! Now out comes Jeff Hardy. He does some of his classic moveset, and including throwing his body at Drew out on the outside of the ring. Drew tries to connect the Future Shock DDT, but it gets reversed into, you know, that weird thing where Jeff randomly lands on your balls? Yeah, that. Jeff tries to go for the Twist of Fate, but it gets reversed into the Future Shock DDT. Jeff kicks out of that, but later gets suplexed outside the ring. Drew tries going for the claymore, but Jeff moves out of the way to hit the Twist of Fate. Oh, are we gonna see it? Swanton Bomb! Yeah! But Drew gets his knees up. He then connects the claymore, and that ends Jeff's night. And out comes Randy Dandy Orton. Well, that gets immediately, or almost immediately, interrupted by some creepy shit. Randy gets counted out. Oh, hi, Sheamus. Sheamus begins brutalizing Drew McIntyre, so much so that Drew loses. I mean, there was some fight back, but, you know, life happens. So it looks like Sheamus will be the last person to exit his Elimination Chamber pod. Well, that's Raw. It was good. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't help that I didn't care for most of the stuff that came on. Miz vs. Kofi was fun, obviously. And the gauntlet match was good, but it's one of the weaker ones. Obviously, I don't really care that much for Lana versus Shayna or the women's tag team. Not that I don't care about Shayna or Nia. It's just their opponents. If Naomi, who does deserve another title run, and Lana, who doesn't. You know, get it? I'm going to be just a little bit upset because Shayna and Nia deserve so much more. Well, especially Shayna. Nia, eh. That's pretty much all. There wasn't exactly anything on this match, on this night. Hurt Business, 50-50 booking, I don't like it. That's going to be all for this Raw. I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10. It's good. It's like so close to being perfect, but they always do the wrong things all the time. So, with that being said, subscribe to Nilsson, and if this is on Nilsson's channel, how dare you not already be subscribed to him? Or watch this video. Seriously, there's 70 of you and 1,000 on my channel. Come on, guys! Whatever. I'm gonna just look at this really fun thing. That thing being the Attitude Era. Okay, bye.